on to example three. There's two parts to this. We have the limit as x approaches infinity. And just like in the previous problem, we're going to divide everything by the highest power of x in the denominator. Okay, so that just becomes a 1 right there. This, we're going to think of it as 4 halves. And so 1 minus 4 is going to give me 1 over x to the 3 halves. Over here, I'll think of this as 4 halves as well. So that's 3x to the 3 halves. And once again, think of this as 4 halves. Negative minus that, so it's negative 5. So x to the 5 halves, the 7 on top. Now if we apply this limit and plug in infinity, this is going to go to infinity. This is going to go to 0. This is going to go to 0. So we have infinity plus 0 over 1 minus 0, which if we work that out is just infinity. There's a part B, so we're still on exercise 3. Limit as x approaches infinity, x squared over x cubed plus 1. Now, if this was x squared over x square root of x cubed like that, we could think of it like this. Now that plus 1 is fairly negligible. We do have to worry about it, but just know that like this is going to give us like a really, it's going to act very similar to this. And so we know that we want to divide everything by x to the 3 halves, okay? So, to do that, we can divide this by x to the 3 halves, divide this by x to the 3 halves, and what's going to happen on top is pretty straightforward. We'll think of this as 4 halves. 4 minus 3 is going to give us 1 half, so we get x to the 1 half on top. Now this part's a little tricky, so I'm going to rewrite it. Like this. And then maybe even think of it as just a negative exponent. So now it's x to the negative 3 halves. So since there's a 2 on the bottom, I can think of it like this now. And since these are both under a square root, I can simply just multiply those. So x to the negative 3 times x to the 3 is going to be just 1, because 3 minus 3 would just be 0. X to the 0 is 1. And then this to this is just x to the negative 3. Okay? And I'm just going to write that as 1 plus 1 over x cubed. And place that right here. Okay, we have our stuff. Now we just need to apply the limit. So the limit as x approaches infinity. Plug it in here, it's going to go to infinity. Plug it in here, it goes to 0. And then we have the square root of 1, which is just 1. Infinity over 1 is just infinity.